productive work. The second one, a tree is being planted by Umesh. It is in passive voice. What is the difference in these two sentences? Here, in the first sentence, Umesh is subject.
Hi all.
And tree is object.
Here to explain
planting is action. That is a verb.
Is derived from
in active voice, subject does an action on object.
Triangle.
Okay.
And
you speak it in active voice. In the second sentence,
of
the subject and object get interchanged.
In the field of science engineering.
A tree.
For example, in
becomes subject here and Umesh becomes
a ship
object
in
here.
Land surveying,
so first we will take subject, hence we say a tree
in, astro,
in the beginning of
the
sentence.
Distance between
a tree
stars,
is
distance between
being planted by whom? By Umesh. So whenever an action, an active action is being done by a subject in active voice, the same
in this way,
subject when becomes
be
object, it is prefixed by the word
in
by
suppose
in passive voice. So, Umesh is planting a tree. A tree is being planted by Umesh. Okay. Similarly, in the second sentence, John paints portraits. Okay.
Then
here, there are only three words.
Height of the kite.
John is the subject.
Is
paints.
Yes.
Is the action, that
and
is verb,
the height of
and portraits is the object.
The balloon in
the here again,
and
the portraits
the
become subject in passive voice,
the
and John becomes object in passive voice, hence it is prefixed by be, by, and painting is the verb which is here used in the passive voice as portraits are painted by John. There are five basic rules that we should always remember whenever we change an active voice into passive voice. The first one is subject and object gets interchanged.
Let us assume that,
okay?
That
is the first rule.
The
second rule is the verb which has been used in active voice is used as past participle in the passive voice. So if it is planting is an action, planting, planted, planted. So plant, planted, planted, planted is the past participle and that is used in passive voice. Here. Paint, paint, painted, painted, okay? So, painted becomes the verb in passive voice. This is the second rule which we should remember. The verb becomes in past participle form. Next, you cannot directly write
sides of the triangle
painted, say portraits painted by John, right? You actually use some auxiliary verb or helping verb before it, like are, is, were, etc. So these are called helping verbs. So before the use of past participle in the passive voice, you actually use a helping verb. The fourth one is the tense of the sentence should not be changed. If it is in present tense, it should be in present tense only. You don't change it into past tense. Like Umesh is planting a tree. It is present.
Can you tell me?
It's actually present continuous. He is now planting a tree. So a tree is being planted by Umesh. In this, still, Umesh is planting a tree. Even in passive voice, it has not changed. Okay. So the sentence tense, whether it is present or past or future, should not change. Next one is the meaning of the sentence should not change. Again, the meaning should not change. For example, if
the
question, if it is a question, it should be a question. I'll give you two examples for how when an imperative or an interrogative sentence is given and it is changed into a passive voice, it doesn't change the meaning. So here there's another example.
Defined as
teacher has helped Ravi with his classwork.
adjacent
here,
side of
in active voice we are saying a direct
so
sentence.
We have identified
teacher
three
has
ratios
helped
of
Ravi
triangle.
With his classwork
sign,
which is in present perfect tense. Okay,
sign which
here teacher becomes the
by hypotenuse
cost, subject
adjacent side by hypotenuse
helped is the action
opposite side
done
by
the teacher
adjacent side.
This is
how
the verb.
Remember this.
Okay, whom did teacher help? Teacher
observe
helped
the
Ravi.
First letter.
Hence, Ravi becomes the object
word.
And not the
observe
classwork.
The first
okay.
Letters.
Teacher has helped
so
Ravi with his classwork.
Her.
Okay. So in the first so rule, subject and object have to be interchanged.
Remember it.
So
easily.
Now the object becomes subject, and Ravi takes the place of the subject. So the sentence starts with Ravi. Ravi.
Tangent is
helped
by
helped since it is already in the
ratios other than this three
past
ratios,
participle form
sign, cost,
you write it helped
yes.
But for that you have to prefix
side,
this with proper auxiliary verbs
side,
right
adjacent
so hence
side
we say Ravi has been helped.
What did you observe from this?
Okay, Ravi has been helped by whom? By his teacher
learned.
So by
yes,
teacher here subject and the teacher here becomes object and rest of the sentence continues with his
angles.
Classwork.
The ratio
so when I say
hypotenuse by opposite side
teacher has helped Ravi with his classwork you should be clear
side.
With what is the object of the sentence when there are two objects like Ravi and classwork. Teacher has helped Ravi. Teacher has not helped the classwork. So hence
finally,
we should be clear what is the object in the active voice to use it as the subject in passive voice.
Angle, which is
here,
also called as cot
who
angle,
is doing
is
the cooking? This is an interrogative sentence. A question is being asked in active voice.
Ratios.
Who is doing
sine,
the cooking? Okay.
Cosine, tangent,
here.
Cosecant.
Cooking is the action done
now,
and the question is being asked who is
A
doing
in this
that cooking.
A, B, C.
You should not get confused here because
B,
there is no subject
three,
or object exactly
A, B,
in the sentence to underline and say that this particular thing is subject or this particular thing is object.
If you find the length of the AC,
in WHO questions when it starts with who, it is always good to
so
use who in the very beginning of the passive voice also
AC.
Like by
how
whom
to find the length of AC.
Okay
by
you should not say
theorem,
cooking is being done by whom
square,
that is wrong
is
you should not say that is
the
not
the
correct passive voice sentence
other two sides of the
in passive voice sentence
so
in active voice sentence when there is a who the passive voice
AB
sentence
AB
always starts with by whom by whom is the cooking being done. Okay, this is a continuous tense so hence we say being done. Done again doing do did done right do did done so past participle is done here that is being correctly used so the second one is right. Use of the helping verb is being. Okay, and the tense has not been changed and meaning we have been asking question in the active voice also and we are asking the same question in the passive voice also. The meaning of the sentence also has not changed. Let us look at the third sentence here. Why have you called me here? This is a little tricky but not that much. Just give it a thought and you can write the passive voice also. In active voice I am asking someone. Okay, who is asking the question? It's I. So, why have you called me here? In passive voice, it becomes why have I been called here
by
you? So, here you is the subject. Being called is the verb and me is the object.
Hypotenuse
when object me
which is
it converts into subject in passive
B.
voice
since
it becomes
secant is reciprocal
I.
cosine
it doesn't say me
why
have me been called no it's
AC
like
AB
me becomes I
by
and
by
why have I been called
cogent
called
reciprocal of tangent can write it right? as adjacent.
So this
by
one
opposite.
Tense has not been changed again. Meaning has not been changed again. Verb is in past participle. Helping verb been has been used here. In the subject and object, you and I have been interchanged. So all the five rules also have been followed when I am converting the active voice sentence. Why have you called me here into passive voice sentence? Why have I been called here by you? So here again I am using
this is 3
by for making the subject into object in passive voice sentence.
The angle is A. Find sine A, cos A, tan A, sin square A plus cos square A.